I'm a lifelong martial artist, and I have a knack for finding talent. Which is why I've traveled more than 10,000 miles from my home in search of the next warrior. This is Asia. Join me, Rich Franklin, three-time middleweight world champion, on a journey to experience the cultures that gave birth to martial arts and meet the rising prospects on this side of the world. We will learn the flavors, the beauty, the customs, and the things Asia has to offer.
I'm okay.
These martial artists will compete for a one championship contract exceeding $100,000 and the honor to be called the One Warrior.
We kick off our adventure in the most populated city in the Kingdom of Thailand, Bangkok. Every year, Thailand's capital attracts millions of people from all over the world. Bangkok is the largest and most developed city in Thailand, but somehow manages to maintain its historical architectures and traditions dating back hundreds of years. For me, traveling has changed my perspective in life, especially on this side of the planet. It gives you the ability to view life through the other side of the looking glass, especially when you're on a mission. Now, if you're traveling with your best buddy, like Jonathan, anything could happen. But definitely working with him on this project will be fun and exciting. Today we're going to Floating Market River. Apparently, like the Floating Market River, it used to be a method of transportation for people, like on boats and stuff, to barter goods and to purchase goods. And so now, like it's basically a market where you get on a boat and you can pull up next to other boats and purchase things, or pull up like to stores that are on shore and purchase things. So it's pretty cool, actually.
Here we are. Let's get out of here.
Hello.
Guys, here we are, walking down to these stone steps, getting on this wooden boat.
Careful.
This thing probably seats like five people. As we're stepping down and about to get onto the boat, Rich gets in the boat first, and I see it start to move a little bit. And then I get on there, and I set my foot on the same side of the boat that he was sitting on.
Yeah, let's just try not to shift weight too much.
And next thing you know, the boat's rocking. And I'm thinking to myself, man, this guy is definitely too big. And you know, I'm thinking he should probably go and get himself another boat.
I don't know if I need to have my own boat. I had everything under control. But they felt like the boat was going to flip over. So now suddenly I'm too fat to fit in the boat, and I have to have my own boat. Hurts my feelings.
Hello.
Once we actually enter the market, the first thing that we pass is this lady on another boat who is selling mooping. It's a barbecued pork dish that we had tried, or I had tried earlier for the first time. We also picked up some fresh coconuts, some of the best coconuts that I had, because they tasted awesome. Like they had just been picked from the tree.
It's so soft, man. I mean, seriously, like.
So we rehydrate with some coconut water and we continue down the floating river. And we come to this store that we decide to stop at, where the lady there is selling trinkets.
Rich starts to get called over by one of the vendors, and she has a collection of various goods over here. You know, she's got clothes, she's got these little figurines of animals. But what draws Rich over is this plate. And I'm thinking to myself, what's this dude doing in Bangkok, and why are you just gonna get a plate?
Hold on, let me, the bigger one.
The prisoner makes it. So they help the prisoner to sell. in a prison do.
Like, the more I learn about this culture, the more amazing it is, because this plate is made by prisoners, and they sell them here at the market. Like, people who are in prison, they're about to come out of prison, so this gives them an opportunity to make some money before they come out of prison, so that when they actually get out of prison, they have money to start, like, to actually start life again. And so it's just an example of how this culture just, they take care of each other. It's really... really intriguing. It's I can learn. We can learn something from that for sure.
So after Rich gets his plate and we continue going down the floating market, we're about to enter this tunnel, and I'm looking in there and I'm trying to see you know, if they got more shops in there or if they've got something else that we haven't seen before. And lo and behold, I see snakes.
That's a real snake?
Yeah. Me personally, I really don't have any kind of issue with snakes. Jonathan, on the other hand, right away says, oh man, I'm afraid of snakes. So naturally, we have to get out of the boat.
I found some boats. Where are we going? Spoon in your coconut, bro.
The second I held that thing, I was like, oh damn.
Oh my god.
Jeez. The snake kind of started wrapping itself around my arms, and it started to hiss. Let's maybe get him off me at this point.
Bum, I'm Rich. Nice to meet you.
Really?
How do you say nice to meet you?
ยินดีที่รู้จัก This is what we do every season, 25 years.
I assume he likes being on the water?
He said it's fun because of the passenger who in the boat, every day is different. Some come and fight on the boat, some come and like be like us, so they, He enjoyed to meet new people every single day.
My last thought when I was exiting the river was thinking, I remember what Baum told me about his favorite part of working the river was just taking people through this experience and seeing them experience something new every day and how much they appreciated that, and that he was actually part of giving that experience to them. And I just remember thinking, like, this is somebody who appreciates the slow-paced simplicity of life.
Hello. Thank you. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
The best thing about Bangkok is waking up to a warm tropical morning. We got up early as we were expecting an overwhelming number of participants to open the competition. Always start my day with a hearty breakfast. We have a long day ahead of us. Tryouts today over at Bangkok Fight Lab. We're excited to get over there and actually see these tryouts, but first and foremost, I gotta eat my breakfast. Secondly, I gotta make sure my crew is well fed also. Here we come, one warrior series. We just pulled up to Bangkok Fight Lab. We have a bunch of people inside waiting for Jonathan and I for the one warrior series. And also, we have two guest judges. Let's go inside and check it out. Everybody, thank you for coming today. Welcome to the first One Warrior Series tryout. So this is a developmental league that One Championship has created. Myself, I am running this. This is my right arm, Jonathan Fong. He is with me today, and we will be conducting the tryouts. Fortunately, we've had two guest judges join us today. Rika and Shannon, I'm sure many of you are familiar with them. This is not the first time that we've had tryouts. We've just been looking for a systematic way to find young talent and then bring the young talent along. So after kicking around all these ideas, we had a meeting of the minds and we all sat down and said, why don't we just create a league, actually go out and recruit the talent and let the talent compete, the best rise to the top, and then offer them a one championship contract. So the idea came about. We designed a one championship contract that exceeds $100,000 and we decided to go out and recruit the talent and we'll have an event and let them compete.
Before the tryouts, Rich and I are sifting through some of the applications and we're just going through stacks and stacks of these applications, and it's getting me really excited because not just the number of local talent or Bangkok-based talents that we had coming on deck, but also the number of international travelers as well. That's just a testament to the depth and the breadth of the One Warrior Series and the reach of One Championship.
Tryouts not only exhaust your knack for finding great talent, sometimes it'll exhaust your patience as well.
Time!
So you better be ready at any given moment. Partho was one of the people that actually caught my eye because he was traveling in from India to try out. And on his tryout application for his martial arts, he had listed boxing and kushti. And I was really interested in seeing his kushti because it's difficult to find high quality wrestlers on this side of the planet. But I've seen kushti wrestlers before out of India. And these guys that are experienced kushti wrestlers are competitive on a global stage. When you watch him try out, like his stand-up, he's very aggressive. Clearly he can box. The moment that we start doing the ground drills, this is where you see this big deficiency. And so I had decided while I was watching the tryout that I'm not going to pick him up.
Partho. You okay?
Flight.
That's what's got you. Especially because you come in from India, man. I really have some high hopes for you here. But, like,
I have much better stamina.
I know. Clearly, we could tell. The problem you're going to run into is, like, you've got to spend some time on your ground game because you're going to come in and get somebody to just lay on top of you. And
no techniques. I know how to get out.
Yeah.
I simply don't have strength right now.
I know.
Thank you.
We can, I've seen you try out now, so we'll do some video stuff, okay? All right. Thanks. Appreciate it.
I think I hurt his feelings or I upset him because his interpretation was that I said that he didn't have any skill.
Problem is, you believe that I do not have any jiu-jitsu or wrestling skills. I feel really hurt with that. I'm just give me one round, two rounds, just let me prove that I have some skills. Today, tomorrow, I was extremely tired. Yes. Extremely tired.
You got your grappling gear?
All right. Hey, Tommy, can you do me a favor?
Yeah.
You grapple with him for 2 minutes.
Grapple with him.
This is exactly what I'm talking about. Look how much you're breathing. Look at Tommy. He's not breathing. I know you traveled, but I'm just saying, you need to work on your game.
I have some skills.
I didn't say you don't have any skills. I'm just saying there are some holes that you need to work on.
I never said I don't have any holes.
Yeah.
I just...
Continue. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disrupt.
Do you need me?
No, I'm good.
Do you want to do MMA next?
No.
I have gloves.
It's okay. He's good. Thank you.
If you got a green light, I'll be ready to go.
Yeah, no, it's good. Thank you, Tommy. I hope that on the back end of this, he actually takes my advice, he goes home, he works on his grappling game, he works on his wrestling game or his takedowns, and comes back a refined athlete. Time will tell. If you want to accomplish your goal, you must stick to your game plan. Don't get distracted, focus on the target, and find the best martial artists in Asia. And that's the One Warrior Series main mission.
So Dech was our first applicant on deck. Right off the bat, the first thing I noticed about this guy is he had the widest smile on.
Once I saw Dech's tryout actually start, and you see him hit the pads, kick the pads, and you see what he's able to do on his feet, that's the part of you that says, okay, this guy, like, clearly with his stand-up game, he has what it takes. Anybody who's standing on the opposite side of the cage with Dech had better figure out how to get the match to the ground, because if not, they're in big trouble.
Shannon, what are your thoughts?
I follow Dech's one.
Yeah.
He's stronger, but he has a very good competitive mind. At first, he looked getting slowed down, right? Mm-hmm. He looked at him, like, getting hyped up. And...
Yeah.
All right. Dech.
Dech is a hard worker, and you could tell that he's quite green with, like, his ground game as compared to his stand-up, but I believe that he's going to close the gap really quickly. Dech being in OWS, this is the time that he has before he actually steps on to a larger platform to close the gap in any kind of discrepancies he has in his ground game. It's this time over the next 4 to 6 competitions that's going to make him more of a complete fighter. And this is part of the reason why I selected him.
Thank you.
Good job.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
I see some potential there. So,
รู้สึกดีใจฮะที่โดนได้รับเลือกให้เข้ามาสู่ One Warrior Series ครับรู้สึกเป็นเกียรติเลยล่ะที่เด็กชาวเขาเป็นเล็กๆคนหนึ่งที่มีโอกาสได้เข้ามาในรายการใหญ่ๆก็พยายามสร้างอาชีพที่ดีกว่าเดิมครับแล้วพยายามทำตามฝันให้มันสำเร็จครับเผื่อวันหนึ่งจะได้แบบเป็นแชมป์โลกในระดับ MMA ระดับโลกเงี้ยเอาเงินตัวนี้ไปช่วยเหลือทั้งบ้านไปช่วยเหลือพ่อแม่ไปช่วยเหลือเด็กๆที่ผมแต่ก่อนเคยเหมือนเขาอยู่
Decide we're taking Dech out to Khao San. Khao San Road is this road that basically at night, you know, all the restaurants open, the bars open, and you're walking down the road and you can do anything there from buy some trinkets, get a massage, eat bugs, and what you know it, that happens to be our first stop.
So what's the best thing to try here?
Oh, I see it. Here we go.
No.
I didn't know you were trying scorpion.
Do you just dig
in? We are caught here already.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not bad.
The hardest part was just getting over putting this thing in your mouth. But once I actually took a bite of it, it didn't taste bad, actually. It didn't taste great. Like, I wasn't like, oh man, let me get a whole bag of these so that I can snack on them the rest of the weekend. But it wasn't a bad tasting snack. It was just one of those things that I remember I was chewing on it for a good 15 or 20 minutes before I'd actually finished it. We decided to go have dinner, got to sit down and get to know Dech a little bit. It was interesting getting to know his backstory because before he moved to Bangkok, like, he actually had a job with his father where they were transporting people after they had died. Even in Bangkok, he carries several jobs. Like, he does, like, carpentry work. He teaches at several different schools, like, lessons at several different schools just to support himself. You can tell that Dech is the type of person who just takes pride in everything that he does.
Why Warrior Series? I think I want to show the world. I need to... My sister is proud to me, yeah.
Do you think you're good enough? Do you think you're ready to compete in the world?
Yes, I can, but I need to practice. I get some techniques more. Yeah, I'm ready to.
Smart man.
Yeah, thank you.
After having spent some time at Des Moines Sidewalk and then sitting down with Dech, one of the qualities that you realize about Thai people in general is that they're very hardworking people. They take pride in every aspect of things that they do. And you can just see that across the board. It's one thing that I respect tremendously about Thai people. next episode of One Warrior Series. Will he or will he not? We'll hang out with the rest of the successful Warriors who passed the tryouts. And still later, we'll eat street food with ONE Championship superstars, Rika Ishige and Shannon Weirchild.
Hey!